Hi everyone, first video of 2021. Welcome back to the channel. It's the M1 Mac Mini. Let's go ahead and open it. Wait, are you saying a knife isn't necessary? Ooh. So this is the M1 Apple Mac Mini. I know I'm late to the party. Most people started getting theirs about a month ago. By the time I actually pre-ordered it, it was backordered because at that time I was finishing up my iPhone 12 coverage. And then Christmas happened, so I got my hands on it as quick as I could. But it doesn't really matter, sure, it's here now. Now this is the base model in all aspects, but rather than 8 GB of RAM, I have 16 GB of RAM. Storage really isn't an issue for me because it's gonna be plugged in all the time, so I'm just gonna plug my SSD into it all the time. I mean, I edit my videos off an SSD, so that's not really an issue for me. But yeah, the reason why I spec'd it out the way I did is because, to be honest, I call this a transition computer. I don't really imagine myself using this long term for several years. We all know that this year Apple's going to announce, you know, redesigned MacBook Pros and a redesigned iMac, and it's kind of just something to keep me going until those come out. And it's actually kind of a tester to see if maybe I could be an iMac user. All my life I've used MacBook Pros, and I've actually used a MacBook Air 2 and a 12-inch MacBook. But I've always wanted to be an iMac user. However, I always really wanted portability. However, since the world has changed, for the first time, I can actually just see myself as a desktop user. Boom. This. So nice. I just love opening up Apple products. I'm not going to even apologize for it. It's always just fun. So, here we are. This is the Mac Mini. Looks good, looks like a really large Apple TV. So this is it here, in all of its glory. Oh, this is nice. This is gonna sit on my desk really well. This is nice, not too heavy. You know what, this is sort of a portable Mac. If I had like a little computer monitor that I could put into a suitcase, I could just travel with this and that. But I'm pretty sure at that point you can just get yourself a MacBook, right? So this is the Mac Mini. Let's see what else is inside the box. We just have our information pamphlets. Just, you know, welcome to your Mac Mini. Yes, I will connect your cheapest Mac to a 6,000 euro Apple display. That's exactly how I intend to use this. Oh, look, they just give you one super-sized Apple sticker. I'm gonna stick this on a car. Don't stick it on your car, it's tacky. We got the power cord here. These are like the same ones they use on the Apple TV. And they're also the same ones I think that Microsoft used for their Xbox One. So this is the Mac Mini in all of its glory. I love silver, by the way. I bought a space gray MacBook over 2 years ago. I have the 2018 MacBook Pro that I'm upgrading from to this. And I just hated the space gray. It actually got dirty quite often compared to the silver. Like, I've had silver Macs for all time before the space gray. So I'm actually really happy to go back to silver. I'd love to see gold. I have a gold iPhone. I would love a gold Mac to go with a gold iPad. I actually like gold quite a bit, but maybe it just isn't professional enough for some people. So this is just your warranty label. Yes, come off. Does anyone else like do the challenge of try not to destroy this? Or am I just nuts? I'm just nuts. So let's go ahead and tear this off. So in terms of ports, we got power, Ethernet, we got two USB 4s, which are basically the same as Thunderbolt 3, but now it's just like a proper USB 4 standard that's open. We got a HDMI, which I love to see, and we got two USB-As and a headphone jack. So even though we only have two USB-Cs, at least we have two USB-As. So as long as I just throw in like my consistent peripherals in USB-A, I can still use USB-C ports because I've actually transitioned most of my devices to USB-C. Because in most situations, you just buy yourself a new wire off Amazon for like 5 or 6 euros. It's not expensive to make a device USB-C. And you only have so many devices that have the same sort of wire. As I said before, I'm upgrading from a 2018 MacBook Pro 15-inch. It was a really expensive computer. I mean, super expensive. And had 32 gigabytes of RAM, 6-core. It was very high-end at the time. And I mean, it's by far until now the fastest Mac I've ever had. but I was never like 100% happy with it. And not just because of the butterfly keyboard. The butterfly keyboard didn't mind me that much. I mean, long term now, it's sort of annoying. There's an issue with the R key that every now and then it keeps double pressing. But there's just something about the experience of it that I didn't love. And as context, before my 2018 MacBook Pro, I had a 2012 MacBook Pro, the first Retina one. And I basically kept that for 6 years. I mean, that was how good of a computer it was. I mean, it got slow towards the end compared to new computers, but it was just such a good machine overall. Like, I felt like it was worth keeping. Whereas with the MacBook Pro that I have, like, I mean, I've only had it for just over 2 years now, and I've just moved on to the Mac Mini. And obviously I'll be moving on from this to whatever Apple releases down the line. In fact, why am I sitting here just talking about it? Let's just go to my room and set this up properly. Come on.
This is my current setup, and what I used to have obviously was the MacBook Pro under the desk, connected with a USB-C cable. It had power, it did video output, one cable, it was really great. So what I'm basically thinking for now is I just put the Mac Mini under here where the MacBook Pro used to be. I'll connect it again via USB-C for the video, and then obviously the power cable. The USB-C cable unfortunately will not power the Mac Mini, but let's go ahead and plug everything in. So this is the USB-C cable. This obviously just goes into the USB-C port like so. And then I'll just obviously put in the power cable, and then into the Mac Mini we go. Oh, we got a light and the monitor has just turned on. So something's happening. I forgot the Mac Mini has a power button. The Mac Mini has a speaker built in also. I'm definitely looking to get a new monitor. As you can see, there is a bit of edge bleeding. I've had this for just over about 2 years now. Let's see if this wireless mouse, I don't think it has a charge. No. Got this old wired mouse. This is actually a really nice keyboard. It's just a pity that I need like multiple devices at once, because I have multiple computers. So I have to turn it off from the MacBook first. Oh wait, don't you have to connect them by wire first? Like, that's how it pairs.
To use English as the main language, press the return key.
We have a keyboard, we have a mouse, at least we have something. I'm sure Apple would not like the marketing to see this setup with just this janky keyboard and mouse combo I've kind of cobbled together. I do not want to do Migration Assistant. I'm actually going to do another video about me putting programs and files onto my Mac from my old MacBook. And we're going to do like a Marie Kondo. I'm going to talk you through my thought process about the new apps I want to install on my Mac and what I'm going to leave behind as I start a new workflow with this computer. Because obviously with the Apple Silicon and the new Big Sur software, I kind of want to explore what my options are in every facet. So not just like my video editing programs, but just even productivity apps and everything else. So do stay tuned for that video. So subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for that. But for now, we're just gonna press not now. This is so smooth though. Like, that's the first thing that I'm noticing, is that just the setup process, like the animations are just like so fluid. So quiet, like it's so silent. That's the first thing. Feels really nice. It's metal, it's smooth, but the corners are quite sharp and precise. That's something I'm noticing about the design of the Mac Mini. And now we just wait for iCloud to set up. I've been like watching a lot of Schitt's Creek, so I just feel like every time I talk, I always want to go into like a Moira Rose. What am I gonna do for lunch? Light, dark, or auto? You know what? I'm gonna go for light because I'm done with dark colors for a little bit, but I inevitably go back to dark mode later on, but we'll go for light mode for now. As I said before, I'm done with space gray. I'm done with things that are dark. We'll just go with this. So as you can see, we're back on the Mac screen. We're all set up and I think we're ready to go. I just want to test a few things. I'm super excited to use this. So this is the computer. Oh wow, this is fast. Oh wow. Two tabs opened up. Apple was like, we're going to give you two Safari tabs to show you how fast this is. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at all this open up. Oh, this is smooth. I can rent Wonder Woman 1984. A bit late for that. I already saw the film, but that's cool. Let's see. We have here in About This Mac, Apple Mac Mini, M1 2020, M1 16 GB of memory. We've got the display, we have the storage. I think we're pretty much good to go. Oh my god, my first request to install Rosetta. This is the app to run Intel programs because Monitor Control hasn't been updated yet. Unfortunately, Monitor Control does not work. Hi everyone, so I just wanted to pop on with a quick update. As you can see, here I am using the Mac Mini, editing the video you're watching right now. It's really fast. It's much cooler than I would have expected. Like, it just feels kind of lukewarmish, even at its most intense tasks. Now, in terms of performance, I was editing a video for a client, and it actually did struggle with more of the 3D graphics-based stuff. It really seems like when it's working with like H.264 or H.265, it's fine. But when you're using something like, for example, 3D text in Final Cut Pro, I'm still noticing that like it hasn't been an instant performance boost. You still need to render stuff like that out. So this is the current Mac Mini setup that I'm currently using, although I will probably have it set up slightly different by my review. This is the USB-C hub that I have in the first USB-C port. I got this in the second USB-C port. I actually changed the monitor to HDMI because there's color calibration issues with USB-C. It will show you completely the wrong colors, everything will look washed out. I've went online, it seems to be something specific with the LG monitors. I don't know why, but on USB-C and the Apple M1 chip, they do not seem to be working well together. I've read people having the issues on Mac Mini, MacBook Air, MacBook Pro, so do be aware. But thankfully, I did connect it with HDMI and it's working great. And then in one of the two USB-A ports, I think it's over here, I just put in my Logitech unifying receiver, which I obviously am using my Logitech keyboard and my Logitech mouse, which is very trusty. So as you can see, I've actually used up most of the ports. I have one USB-A left, which is perfect for like a thumb drive or another hard drive, because sometimes I can be working with two different hard drives externally. I'm going to leave it off here for now and finish setting up the Mac. Do stay tuned for my next video, which will be me showing you what I installed on the Mac and the different files I transferred over from my old laptop and the stuff I didn't transfer over. I think that's going to be more interesting. I'm going to Marie Kondo my Mac setup. And of course, the Mac Mini review, which of course I'll review. So do subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for those videos. And if you like the video, do give it a thumbs up. And if you plan on getting a Mac Mini M1, or if you have any questions about it, or my setup, or anything else I've shown in the video, do drop a comment below. But other than that, I hope you guys are staying safe and well. Welcome to 2021, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.